Hello, this is Mike Gafford. I work for Department of Wildlife Resources, hatchery manager at Vic Thomas Hatchery in Brookneal, Virginia. The Vic Thomas Hatchery is one of three warm water hatcheries in the Commonwealth. The other hatchery is Buller Fish Hatchery, and then we have King and Queen Fish Hatchery. All three hatcheries work in collaboration. Here at the hatchery, we produce both walleye and striped bass. But let me focus on the walleye. Walleye are collected at the beginning of March and then throughout the month of March from the Stanton River, which runs parallel to the hatchery here. The broodstock are collected using electrofishing techniques. The aquatic biologists assist us in collecting the broodstock. Broodstock are brought up to the hatchery, both the males and the females. We collect the milt from the males to use for the spawning process. We hold that milt in cold temperature to preserve it until the females are ready to spawn. When a female is ready to spawn, we'll remove her from the tank that we're holding her in and use the milt from the males to mix together in a mixing bowl where we mix both the eggs and the milk together. After about 20 seconds, we'll add clay because the eggs are adhesive and they would stick to any kind of rocks or sticks or tree limbs or anything in the river. Without adding a mixture of clay to that, the eggs become adhesive, stick together, and we cannot incubate the eggs in a McDonald jar. The eggs will incubate in the McDonald jar for about 11 to 13 days. And at that point, they will hatch out, swim out of the jar, and we hold them in an aquarium for about 3 days. At 3 days, we'll take those larvae to a pond, place them into a pond which has natural food in it, which we call zooplankton. They'll feed on that natural feed for about 30 days. At 30 days, we'll start to drain the pond down into a collection chamber or kettle, harvest the fingerlings from that kettle, bring them up to the hatchery, enumerate those fingerlings, and then we do our stockings into the lakes and reservoirs of the Commonwealth. After we have spawned the males and the females, we return them back to the river. We do our best to try to make sure we cause as little harm to the fish, and we've been very successful in doing that. The staff at Vic Thomas consists of three full-time staff people, and then during the busy, hectic period of the hatchery season, we'll bring aboard between 4 to 5 seasonal workers. We have many long hours during the hatchery season to produce these fingerlings. It's a very condensed work period, so it takes a very large team to produce the fingerlings for the stocking in the lakes and reservoirs of the Commonwealth. The team has worked really hard and has produced a high number of good quality eggs and give us the opportunity to stock our ponds and help other hatcheries in stocking their ponds. If you have more questions or anything that we can do to help you, first visit the agency website and you'll find a plethora of information there.